This video is an intro to ionic bonding, so I'm going to go over the definition of ionic bonding and then a couple of things that you're going to have to know for your class. So first, the definition is that ionic bonding is the type of bonding that happens between a metal and a nonmetal. So how do you know if that's what's happening? Well, we have to go to our periodic table and we have to know what the line is in between metals and nonmetals. So most of it happens on this line, where everything on the left-hand side is a metal, and everything on the right-hand side is a nonmetal. So the only exception to this is hydrogen, which is over here on the left-hand side, and this is also a nonmetal. And so besides that, everything inside here, these are all of your metals. And so if you have a bond that's happening in between something that's in these two categories, this is going to be an ionic bond. And then one other note here, this little ladder goes right in between the semi-metal or metalloid category. And so that's something that has properties of both metal and nonmetal. But in general, the metalloids and semi-metals are broken up into some are still considered metals and some are still considered nonmetals. So this staircase is what you want to follow. So now let's learn some facts about ionic bonding. So a big fact about them is that electrons are completely transferred from one atom to another. So that's different than the other type of bonding you're probably learning about, covalent bonding. That's about sharing electrons. In ionic bonding, there's no sharing. One atom gives electrons to another atom, and the other atom just completely takes them. And so because of this, because you have a full electron exchange, all atoms will have full charges. That'll be important in a second during examples. And another thing is that bonds, ionic bonds, are drawn as dashed lines. It doesn't matter exactly how many dashes you do, it's just if you want to show an ionic bond, you do a bunch of little dashed lines like this. And so another important thing is that in ionic bonds, the bonds do not represent anything physical. All they represent is an attraction between the atoms, or now they're ions, now that electrons have been transferred. And so this is different than covalent bonds, where the bond literally represents two electrons that are being shared. In ionic bonds, it's just saying, hey, these two atoms, these ions are attracted to each other. So now let's do some examples of identifying ionic bonds. So these are four different possible scenarios, and let's just identify what type of bond they would make. So you just look for where they are on the periodic table and then assign if they're metal or nonmetal. So sodium is up here at 11. That's in a metal category. And chlorine is over here. This is in a nonmetal category. So this is our definition, metal, nonmetal. So this is going to go ahead and this is going to be an ionic bond that form in between sodium and chlorine. So going along, below it we have H. So that's our big exception. H is a nonmetal, even though it's on the left-hand side. And then we have chlorine back over on the right-hand side, also a nonmetal. So this is not going to be ionic because we have two nonmetals. That is actually covalent. And so now, top right, we have calcium, that's right here, left-hand side, that's number 20, so that's a metal. And we also have copper, so that's right here in the middle, transition metal, that's also a metal. So again, this is not going to be ionic because this is not a metal and a nonmetal. This is just two metals, which means that they actually form a metal bond. All right, and so last but not least, we have magnesium, that's over here on the left-hand side, number 12, that's a metal. And we have oxygen up here on the right-hand side, number 8. That's a nonmetal, so this will be ionic. So let's go ahead and draw out these two ionic bonds. So now let's go ahead and draw out our two ionic bonds. And so for this portion, I'm going to be talking about valence electrons. So if this doesn't apply to you yet, don't worry about it. Or if you feel shaky on valence electrons, go and watch my video on them, and then come back to this part. But for right now, let's say we have our sodium and we have our chlorine. So now we need to identify valence electrons. That's done by whatever column your element is in. So sodium is right here in the first column, so it has one valence electron. I'm just going to draw it like this. And chlorine's over here in our seventh column, so it's going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And now, back to the octet rule, anything that has 7 electrons is going to want to have one more. And anything that just has one valence electron is going to want to get rid of that one electron. So what's going to happen is that when these two meet up, sodium's going to say, hey, I'm going to go ahead and give you this valence electron. I actually don't want it. And chlorine's going to say, great, I want that valence electron because that gets me to 8. And so what's going to happen is when that electron transfers, now you have a sodium who's lost one electron. So because you've lost an electron, your charge is positive because electrons themselves are negatively charged. And now your chlorine, that will have gained its electron and it'll have a charge of 1- because it got something that was negative. So now it has a charge of 1-. So this is what I mean by full charges. Every atom in an ionic bond is going to have a full charge because there's been some type of electron transfer. And so now, because opposite charges are attracted to each other, that's what keeps these two ions together. So that's how we represent it with these dashes. So because one is positive and one is negative, they're attracted to each other, and so we show that with dashed lines. All right, so let's go ahead and do another example. So if we have our magnesium and oxygen, let's go ahead and look at the valence electrons. So magnesium right here in the second column, so it's going to have 1, 2 valence electrons, and oxygen in the sixth column right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Magnesium is going to want to get rid of its 2 valence electrons. Oxygen is going to want to get 2. And so again, these two are perfectly made for each other. What's going to happen is magnesium is going to say, okay, here we go. There's one electron I'll give you, and I'll give you this electron. And now magnesium will get rid of all of the electrons in its last shell, and oxygen's last shell will be full. So when we draw it out, it'll be magnesium got rid of 2 electrons, so its charge is 2+. Oxygen gained 2 electrons, so its charge will be 2-. And once again, the opposite charges are going to make those two ions attract to each other, so a dashed bond is going to be here. And we don't have to worry about showing 2 dashed bonds because 2 electrons transferred. It's completely fine just to show the 1. All right, so that's a summary of ionic bonding. Hope it was helpful, and happy studying.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to subscribe, click around, and watch my other tutorials. And as always, happy studying.